What's growing in your vagina? No, it's probably not teeth. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. We've talked before about the microbiome inside of us here on DNews, from how our guts affect our moods to poop transplants, but did you know the vagina is its own healthy, balanced ecosystem? That's right, ladies, you've got an entire ecosystem between your legs. First off, some studies indicate that you don't need douches, so please stop using them. I know a lot of you do, and an estimated 20% to 40% of American women between the ages of 15 and 44 say they use a vaginal douche. Unfortunately, douching might actually mess up this down-under dynamic community. Your vagina is cleaning itself. It's supposed to smell like vagina, not like roses or peaches or whatever. So what does a healthy vagina look like? Well, there might not be one type of healthy vagina. There's natural variation in the fauna of the female bits. Researchers used to think vaginas dominated by the bacteria lactobacillus are the healthiest, but some studies suggest there are at least five types of bacterial communities that like lady parts. These colonies vary in people from different ethnicities and from person to person and even week to week in the same person. Some researchers from the University of Maryland even think it's the fluctuation of bacteria that signals a healthy vagina. We've got a pretty cozy relationship with these guys. We provide them a warm and moist place to grow, and they provide us with protection. Not only do they colonize the space to squeeze out any unwanted inhabitants, but they produce lactic acid, which helps keep the vagina very strongly acidic, with a pH of around 4.5, which is similar to beer. This makes it harder for other nasty things and infections to grow. Some studies suggest that vaginal bacteria is important for baby's immune system. As a baby moves through the birth canal during childbirth, it picks up some of mom's bacteria. A study published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences showed that the babies born from C-sections are actually missing certain crucial bacteria. Missing this first colonization of bacteria from mom means their immune systems don't get a chance to learn good bacteria from bad, and could leave the infants with an increased risk of immune disorders like asthma and food allergies. But this ecosystem can get out of balance. Just like when the gut's ecosystem gets out of balance, people can get ulcerative colitis, people with vaginas can get bacterial vaginosis. Bacterial vaginosis is a relatively common condition. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says, in fact, it's the most common vaginal infection. It's basically when the microbiome gets a little out of whack. Research from the Washington University School of Medicine in St. Louis showed a bacteria called Gardnerella vaginalis is likely the cause. It leads to a shedding of cells in the vaginal wall, exposing sensitive underlying tissue, leaving some women vulnerable to STIs and UTI. But it's easier to study something when stuff goes wrong, and researchers still are unsure about what a right vaginal microbiome looks like. Like we like to say on DNews, more research is clearly needed. So hold off on trying new things like douches or peach-scented stuff. Your nether regions are probably normal and fine, so just relax, okay? Switching gears for a second, we are really happy that our new channel Seeker launched this week. Here on DNews, we take a look at the news from a science angle, and they take a look at the news from a human side. Like this video here explaining why Egypt is destroying one of the oldest cities on Earth.
Now they're being forcibly removed from their own homes by their own government. The more they endure, says one expert on the region, the more susceptible the 10,000 people who are being displaced are to jihadi recruitment.
So make sure you check that video out, it's the first link in the description, and subscribe to Seeker so you never miss an episode. All right, so do you have any other weird body questions? Let us know in the comments below. And while you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to watch new episodes of DNews every day of the week.